كل شيء بك موزي الحمد لله الحمد لله مان نستاهل غير الحمد لله زين نعمه اسلامي زين نعمه الحمد لله كنو الحمد لله مان انا سو هاوز يور فاميلي دي ودت
They're okay with it. Okay. My sister is married to a Muslim guy, so okay. My niece is a Muslim.
Ah, mashallah.
My mom is a devout Christian.
Oh, she's not listening.
No. She's stubborn. She doesn't want to hear nothing.
Subhanallah.
It's one of those things I just have to kind of accept.
Yeah.
But at the same time, just keep making dua.
Yeah, man, like guys, assalamu alaikum.
Yeah.
You know where it is? You know, I was speaking earlier on. What stop people to accept Islam, even though it make clear sense? Either it's something which is a social factor or psychological factor. Psychological factor means your mother, she looks at big step. She thinking, oh, are you telling me all my life I've been wrong?
That's what she said to me.
Yeah. You see, that's called psychological factor. So even though she knows the truth, even though she knows her belief, and guess what, is not by necessities, but because of that psychological factor, it's preventing her, but that's not a valid reason in front of God.
No, it's emotional attachment as well.
Yes, that's it. You know, awatif also. Either sometimes what happens, social factor. Social factor mean, he knows Islam is the truth,
yeah.
But he thinks, okay, now if I become Muslim, my family will come against me.
Yeah.
You know, I'm going to lose friends and families, so you will turn away from Islam.
Yeah.
That's why no one ever in history will try to reject Islam intellectually.
No. Anyone
try to do that, he's lying to himself.
No, that's crazy. It's the same way when I came to it, it was through intellectual reasons.
Yeah.
Being in Christianity is more emotional, believing in God. And
That's for your sins and
What you find is they don't actually read the scripture.
Yeah, that's right. That's
for
right.
For the most part, it's what you're taught by like
the priest.
Yeah, the priest
and the pastor. Yeah.
Another issue that I used to have is like when you go to like a church, right, yeah. And then they say to open your Bible,
yeah,
and everyone can't find what they're looking for. That used to bother me as a child. I just remember that we open a child a Bible, he opens.
Yeah.
And then we're looking for a certain verse. It's not in this one, it's not in that one. I'm like, something weird. But
something's not normal.
Yeah.
You know, I have my friend, he has a revert. He always with me, I don't know where he's gone. He said same thing, he said, he's a revert, yeah. He said when he used to go to this Christian meeting, always said, Jesus came to me.
Yeah.
And he used to say, how come Jesus never came to me, man?
Yeah.
And I, you know, so subhanAllah, alhamdulillah, he became Muslim. Again, what is emotional? Like when we speak to Christians, where they say, you cannot understand it because you don't have the Holy Spirit.
No.
But in order for you to have the Holy Spirit, you have to become a Christian.
Yeah, yeah.
So I have to be blind, I have to have a blind faith, then believe. Doesn't make any sense. That's what they do.
That's the same conversation I had. Like, obviously, for the first time when I come Christian,
yeah,
I was excited.
When you become Muslim, mean?
Yeah. So I was excited because I'd watched, when you watch like Ahmadidad videos and stuff like that. I was thinking, now I'm ready to go speak to my mother.
Oh.
The first time I went to speak to her.
Yeah, you got excited.
I lost that battle.
It was
an emotional time for me because I lost it. And I was thinking, I didn't understand why I lost it. I was looking at it, I was thinking, I'm trying to tell you the truth here.
What you're
believing in.
Yeah.
It's absolute nonsense in a way. But obviously, you know, being my mother, I'm thinking,
of course,
I still have to have the respect.
No doubt.
Try to find a way to break it down.
Yes.
I didn't have the tools to break it down then.
Yes.
And then up until I come to a verse where, you know, in the Quran, when Allah says to the Prophet Sallallahu
Alaihi Wasallam,
you cannot guide who you want. You know,
yeah, إنك لا تهدي من أحببت ولكن الله يهدي من يشاء.
Yeah, that verse, it kind of stuck with me. And then from then, I had to come to peace with it. And I was like, you know what, there's other ways to do it. This is not the way to attack her. Because she felt, so a lot of times with Christians, we're talking to them. Because like,
it's like personal attack.
My sister's a pastor. My mom is, when I mean devout, very devout.
Devout,
so,
yeah.
When you're speaking to them, they feel it's an attack.
Already, straight away.
So it's like, first thing she said to me, she's like, in your religion, do you miracles? And I was like, what do you mean miracles? Do you heal the sick, all of that stuff? And that completely kind of threw me off because then I was like, I didn't have the language. But then later down the line, you know, she starts to understand a little bit. But as far as her coming, I said, you know, I deserve to keep making.
You know about this miracle thing, They say when you read on the body in the name of Jesus, you start acting up. That doesn't prove Christianity is correct. Because I done ruqya, you know? When I do ruqya, remember, I see ruqya people, we see them, the way it's not moving. I can't say to the person, believe in Islam is the truth because of ruqya.
No.
That's why what differentiates Islam from any religion, Islam gives you universal proof.
Yeah.
Proof that everyone can analyze.
Yeah.
Not a personal proof, You understand? Because the Hindus say the same thing.
Yes.
Buddhists say the same thing. So what happened with that? Sometimes the jinn can be someone who's just deceiving you.
Yeah.
Deceiving, making believe what you're saying is true. You understand? Because remember, when you deal with the jinn, with the demons, you are dealing with the unseen. Like, I had situations when I done the ruqya on a jinn, and the jinn become Muslim.
Oh.
Now, did he become Muslim? Allah, alhamdulillah, but Allah knows best. Because
yeah.
It's the unseen. He said, before I leave, let me take shahada. I said, take shahada, I left. But again, can I say for sure he become Muslim? Allah alam.
Yeah.
Because why? It's the unseen.
Yeah.
So can I say, can I? And if you notice my da'wah, even I had this many personal experience with the people, but I never used it in my da'wah to prove Islam is the truth.
Yeah, no, there's no need.
Yeah, no, because what I have universal proofs. You understand? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he read the Quran, the Sunnah, and so on. Understand? That's what makes Islam so beautiful.
Yeah, no, it's very much intellectual. The first time even when I heard Ahmadiyya like, speak, right?
Yeah, rahimahullah.
And then I was, first things I looked at him, I was standing because I knew a lot of stories like from Yusuf alayhi salam.
Yusuf. Yeah, yeah.
So no, these stories growing up,
Moses, yeah, yeah, Abraham, Noah, yeah.
But I had a distorted version.
I like that one.
I had this man standing there and he's telling the stories. And I was like, what is he talking about?
Yeah.
Now I'm hearing them in versions that I've never heard.
Heard them before, yeah.
So he's, you know, he's battling these Christians and then they cannot answer his question.
Then when he was after the man.
Yeah, I never knew about like Islam.
Islam, yeah, yeah.
What is Islam?
Yeah, what is it?
My first encounter.
Yeah.
He's speaking. And then it intrigued my curiosity.
Curiosity, yes.
Like, let me look and see what this man is.
They say curiosity killed the cat.
Yes.
But no, curiosity saved the cat.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
A good example.
Yes, yes.
That's a good curiosity.
I became curious and I became obsessed. So now I need to find out.
I need to learn.
Yeah, I need to find what this guy is talking about.
Yeah.
I went through a journey.
Mashallah, mashallah.
Locked myself in my house for about...
Subhanallah, just reading and searching.
Yeah, I was reading everything. I was going through the Quran, going through a couple of deeds here and there and stuff like that. I was just going through a lot of
subhanallah.
Watching a lot of videos. But then in that time and I used to call myself Muslim, but I didn't take shahada. I didn't know you could take shahada.
Oh, you have to take shahada. Allahu Akbar.
Yeah, I didn't know.
Allahu Akbar.
Then,
but you don't have, you know, sorry to cut you, Akhi Yusuf, yeah? You don't have to say shahada to become Muslim.
Oh.
Yeah, Ibn Qayyim, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, it's sufficient someone say, yes, I believe what Prophet Muhammad came is true and I'm a Muslim.
Uh-huh.
It's enough. But shahada, so it's no condition you have to say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Muhammad Rasulullah. Ibn Qayyim said, there's different way to say it. Because Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Muhammad, I believe, I accept Islam is true, and I'm Muslim, and I submit to Allah the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That's seven. But shahada is what? Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
I didn't know.
Just a benefit, I just had to share it.
Oh,
from Ibn Qayyim.
I didn't know, I went through a long period. I think it was a period of maybe 5 years when I was looking into Islam.
Yeah.
And then I used to just call myself Muslim. Anyone asked me, I said, yeah, I'm Muslim.
Subhanallah.
That's what happened. But then later, I was like, oh, I need to take it. Let me find out. How do you become
a Muslim? How do you become literally a Muslim?
Yeah. This was during the time of lockdown. So,
subhanallah.
And I couldn't go to no man's kid or anything like that.
Yeah.
And I just found out, obviously, I can do it by myself. I was in my house.
Yeah.
And it was lockdown. You couldn't go anywhere. You couldn't go
of course. The first lockdown, huh?
Yeah.
Look, everything was
for about two years or something. Yeah. So
subhanallah.
I just increased on research and looked at a lot of things, and then it was all intellectual.
Of course, you know, one thing, Yusuf, look at how Allah has been glorified in the Quran.
Yeah.
And look the way they speak about Allah in the Old Testament, the New Testament.
Yeah.
Like crazy. In the Old Testament, regrets.
Yeah.
The Old Testament, God became very worried because people are speaking one language.
Yeah.
He created the heavens and the earth in 6 days, 7th day rested and refreshed. You know, and that's 11 tickets. Refreshed, you know, refreshed means re-energized.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
That's the nature of God. You come to the New Testament, nonsense. Again, when you compare the historical or the stories of the Prophet and messengers in the Quran with the stories of the Prophet and messengers in the Old Testament and the New Testament, you can see the Prophet in the Quran, they've been glorified, well respected. Why? Do you know why, Akhi Yusuf? Imagine you have kids. Do you have kids?
No.
May Allah give you righteous kids. Imagine you have a daughter or a boy. I said, look, there's a teacher. He's going to teach his child. But that teacher, he just had intercourse with his own daughters. Would you allow him to teach your child?
No.
If you go out, this guy's no more.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
So Allah is the most wise. When Allah chose the prophets and messengers, He chose those who were known amongst the nation to be trustworthy, truthful, honest. You know? Moses. You look to, in the story of the Old Testament, the one that called people to worship the calf is Aaron. But in the Quran, no, it's not Aaron, it's Samiri.
Yeah,
Allah defend Aaron.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So you can see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Quran to defend the owner as equal of the Prophet and the messengers. So Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, logically, rationally, with our al-fitrah, with our natural inclination, a man that is defending Prophet and messengers in a good way, and he's not from God, but you claim you book from God by speaks about the Prophet and messengers worse than Hitler and Stalin.
Yeah, that didn't make any sense.
David.
A lot of them, yeah.
David, he was, according to the Old Testament, a liar. He set up his own friend, his best friend, because he fell in love with a woman.
His wife,
akhi. A'udhu billah. Prophet Dawood, he was a righteous prophet, alayhi salatu wasalam. We love him, you know? You come to Prophet Noah, he got drunk. A'udhu billah. So rationally, a man that receiving A'udhu billah, that's they claim. A man is receiving the revelation from Satan, he speaks in a best way, in a perfect way about the prophets and messengers who God chose. This book, the Bible, they claim from God, but he speaks about God and the prophets and messengers in an evil way. How can you judge? How can you claim your book, who is full of disrespect of God, disrespecting the prophets and messengers from God, but the other book who respects God, glorify the prophets and messengers from Satan?
It doesn't make any sense.
Subhanallah.
When you put it like that, my first encounter was reading the stories of the prophets.
The messengers, yes.
Ibn
Kathir.
Yeah.
Ibn Kathir, may Allah have mercy upon him.
I read that book, Stories of Prophets, and I went through that whole thing. And then that's when I realized, I was like, this is all wrong. Because now when you're hearing stories from the Bible, you're like, who's actually writing this? This is another thing I stumbled on. I was like, who's actually writing this?
Yes.
And then when I did the research now to look into the Bible to see, to find the writers, anonymous.
So you went deeper, you couldn't find even the writers.
I went deep because it was a thing where I was trying to prove, because my first encounter was I used to do music. So I was trying to find why people worship the devil. So this is where I stumbled upon it. And then now going into it, I was to write such a
of course, it's about Solomon.
Solomon
and about God, how he described the woman's body.
That's one of the things I asked, like, my family. I was like, if this is the word of God, why would you have such a film that I can't read to my nieces? Now I have to read this book to them. I can't read this stuff to them because they're going to look at me and say, like, what am I exposing them to?
Yeah.
So it doesn't make sense to me. So
even about Isaiah, for example, sorry to cut you, Isaiah is the prince of the prophets and messengers. Isaiah, he claimed his miracle was 2 years to walk around naked.
Huh?
That's an Old Testament. That's a miracle. Sign. So Isaiah's sign was he has to walk naked for 2 years. A'udhu billah, that's crazy. That's crazy. But alhamdulillah, Allah got to Islam is a ni'mah, alhamdulillah. That's why, you know, that's why I always mention in my videos. If you have a sound listening and natural inclination, you accept Islam. Alhamdulillah. But your story is very amazing, mashallah, for sharing it with us. You know, even for people out there, Christians, hearing your story, can subhanallah.
Yeah, I thought I'd come out and this for the first time. My friend was the one
who
was like, oh, we have to go.
No, alhamdulillah, may Allah bless you. Marhaban. Barakallahu fikum.
I don't want to take too much.
No, may Allah bless you. It's my pleasure to meet you, know. May Allah bless you, Yusuf. Khalid.
Omar,
Khalid, barakallahu fikum. Jazakum Allah khair. May Allah bless you. Barakallahu fikum. ما شاء الله. السلام عليكم.